Worthington, was a brickie, but turned to acting and has since built a career in Hollywood. He made his film debut in Bootmen, put a modern twist on Shakespeare, and gave an award-winning performance in Somersault before stealing scenes in Terminator Salvation. Now, after being handpicked for the starring role in James Cameron's 3D epic adventure blockbuster, he experiences life as an avatar.
You are not in Kansas anymore. You are on Pandora. We have an indigenous population called the Nabi.
The concept is to drive these remotely controlled bodies called avatars. Outstanding. Strong prey on the weak, and nobody does a thing.
They've sent us a message that they can take whatever they want. But we will send them a message. That this is our land!
And this is our Sam Worthington!
I just wanted to say, if you know, I feel a bit underdressed because of what you just said, and I do know that a lot of people got a tear out because of it, because we've grown up watching you, like myself. But I thought that I'd exactly dress for your damn barbecue.
Sounds perfect to me. And I realised during the little intro piece there, it was the coming out the other end line that was what people were sniggering at. Well, have you brought presents?
Yeah, I've brought
presents,
mate. Here you go. So, well, I've got my jersey in case I get, like, cold. but I thought, my mate goes, he goes, you can't go to a mate's barbecue and be a mooch.
Yes, good.
So I bought some snaggers.
Hey, good boy!
Straight up. I also bought you, you got to be a present. I bought you I don't know if you're cooking or not, but he bought you an apron.
Nice.
If you look,
it's like a James Bond apron.
It's licensed the grill. So I thought it was pretty good.
And I thought you couldn't top plastic boobs, but there you go.
I tried to trust him, mate, I lost. And the other thing is, you're a Perth boy like myself. You know, you don't go to a good barbecue, you got your beer, but you need a box of wine.
Oh!
It's not piss fart around.
The best thing I love about these is, like, I grew up probably like you. I grew up probably like Rove, probably like a lot of yous, that when you've had a bit too much of this, you bring the silver lady out to dance and you blow her up and use her as a pillow. So,
it's a perfect end of night.
After what you just said then, let's get on it, mate. I'm telling you right now.
Sounds good to me.
You know, screw the water, put me on it.
How do you crack it? Was spill it all
the thing
over
is,
the desk.
I know yours was vodka, so that's ridiculous. It's a shame.
Oh, there we go.
Here we go,
it's good Margaret River stuff,
yeah,
too.
There we go.
So, now, Avatar, I saw... Cheers. Oh, cheers to you, my friend.
There we go.
Cheers indeed. Hey, everybody. Oh, yeah! Okay, so you've got a couple of huge films on their way, and Avatar's the one that we're about to see.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I caught a half an hour of it the other day, and it is absolutely amazing. Now, it's using, as we saw there, all this sort of computer-generated technology. How much of you is actually in this movie?
It's 50-50. The movie's basically, like, okay, for those who don't know, it's the movie's by James Cameron. Now, Jim did Terminator, Aliens... Titanic, for goodness sake. So it's took him about 10 years or 12 years to make another film, and he's come out guns blaring. He what he said to me when I first met him was he wanted to bring people back to the cinema. This is a 3D epic like no one's ever seen before. How you shoot it is, as you saw, what I look like is big and blue with a tail. He said on a planet that is computer generated, but when you put your 3D glasses on, you're going to get lost in this planet. And that's the way we shoot it. It took me 14 months to shoot it. It took Jim 5 years to make it.
And you were hand-picked for this role, weren't you?
Yeah, the guy's an idiot. I don't know what he was thinking.
So when you get called to go in for the audition, did you believe that you'd be here at the other end?
Well, I'll be straight up. At the time, I was going through a bit of a crisis. I was about to turn 30, so this is like a couple of years back.
Yeah, washed up.
I was washed up. I was thinking, no one's going to hire this dude. And I literally, I sold everything I owned. I had an auction at my house with my mates. And I'm dead set true. And I sold everything and kind of went, thought I'd go live in my car. And just kind of, you know, like what you're about to do yourself, try and figure out. the more you're just trying to figure out where you fit into the world, where you fit into your life. And, you know, at the time, you know, I get a phone call going, can you do this audition? Did an audition in Australia. Didn't know who the director was, what the project was, anything like that. I then, you know, did what I did, and about a week later I get a phone call going, look, Jim Cameron wants to fly you to America. I said, what for? He said, that was the movie. I go over and meet him, and I said to him, look, I'm living in my car, mate. I've got nothing to lose, so it means I've got everything to gain, which means I'm going to give you damn everything. And for 6 months, I went to work with that man to convince the studio to risk X amount of dollars on a guy from Australia. And I think the good thing about Jim is, you know, he's a lot like Australians in the sense of, you know, you put it all on black, you take that risk on an unknown guy, and you go to work. And, you know, I got lucky enough that we managed to convince the studio to take that risk.
And when you shoot a film like this, I assume it's a lot of running around on an empty set.
It's two things. You shoot it live action, like you saw me when I was live, yeah? Now, the other part, when you're blue, there's a place called the volume. The volume is about an area about as big as this, which is, it's completely grey, there's nothing on it. There's 190 infrared cameras, and you wear a Velcro wetsuit with silver balls on it, and you wear a helmet, and you've got green dots all over your face. You look like ridiculous, like you're in Cirque du Soleil or something like that. And you basically...
Yes, you heard that, Cirque du Soleil. You look ridiculous.
And then that's the thing. So with a scene like, okay, you see the birds flying and you see us jumping on the birds. So they build like a rig, like something like this, yeah? So something like this will be, they put dots on this, and this will be like the bird.
Yep.
And then what you basically do is you ride the fucking bird like this. And that's what you get, all right? Excuse my language.
What are they going to do? Now, also, I mean, you've got Avatar, Clash of the Titans is coming up. Like, we just saw you recently in the Terminator movie.
Yeah.
This was the one where Christian Bale did a spacker on set,
he went off like a pork chop.
He did his nut on set.
Were you there
when it happened?
I wasn't there. That was round two.
Was it really?
Yeah, and round one got out because of your body mics that you got on. So I've got to watch myself tonight, and I just proved that screwed, didn't it? But the thing is, you know, I remember I said to Christian, you know, I sent him an email saying, mate, you know, you're famous, because they made a remix of him.
It was a dance mix?
Yeah,
it was all over YouTube.
They put him on Family Guy. You know, I loved it. So I said, you're famous. Good on you. And he wrote back the whole rant to me, dead set, the whole rant going, you're a nice guy, but you're unprofessional. You know, screw you, do all this. So you can see he realised he went off. And, you know, he apologised on some radio show. And, you know, and the thing is with Christian, in his defence, he's a quiet guy. And wears track pants to work and... Normal, most quietest man, right? And I asked him once, when he was doing Batman, he said the cowl gets real hot and the cape gets really heavy. And he said he wanted to take him off, but he didn't want young kids to see him, you know, without the cowl.
Absolutely.
To lose the illusion. So they put him in like a little tent. So there's this guy, he's sitting in the tent, and he wondered for about half a day why no one's coming to talk to him. Because everyone on the outside is going, well, Christian's preparing. You know, you don't want to go near him. He's, you know, be careful. He's too crazy. You know, he is intense. All right, and that was the thing. And when you meet him, he's, you know, he'd be paddling in that pool now, drinking about half of that, having a good time.
Well, the show's not over yet,
you're more than welcome to be
a Christian Bale Worthington.
It is. He's a nice guy, mate.
Well, are you ready, Sam Worthington, for your public probe? At last, ever public probe. All right. You ready? Annette from Montrose, Victoria, have you used your tap dancing skills since Bootmen?
I didn't even use my tap dancing skills in Bootmen. I did a lot of this, and they cut me out.
That's how Kermit the Frog did it. Tara from Peakhurst, New South Wales, what can you always be relied on to do after a few drinks?
We'll soon find out, won't we?
And Hank from Mackay in Queensland, does James Cameron really threaten actors with knives?
Yes.
Does he really?
Yeah. Well, that machete, he's got a thing of if a mobile phone goes off on set, he nail guns it to the wall. So you know full well on the exit that you never have your mobile phone go off on set. That's it. Yeah.
That's Hollywood for you, kids. You can catch Sam and his alien friends when Avatar opens on December 17 across Australia and New Zealand. You
Thanks
do not want
me,
to
mate.
Miss this one. Sam Worthington.
Awesome.
Thanks, mate. Good to see you. Thanks for coming on. Go! Do what you got to do! We'll be right back!
Still the season finale of Rove. Hamish and Andy, Pete Space, Judith Lucy, philosophisationer Ryan Shelton, Powderfinger will perform their latest hit, and the last ever Kevin Rudd PM.